All right, we're going to look at another algorithm that kind of takes the idea of random restarts one step further. Instead of just waiting until you hit a local optimum to decide that you're going to randomly restart, there's always a chance of taking a step in a downward direction while you're trying to do your hill climbing. And the algorithm that we're talking about in concretely is called simulated annealing. So the basic idea is that we don't always improve. Sometimes we actually need to search. We need to take the point where we are now and wander away from it with the hope of finding something even better. And you can think of this as being related to the notion of exploring and exploiting. That hill climbing, what it's doing is always trying to exploit. It's always trying to climb its way up the hill as quickly as it can, which can lead it to getting stuck. Exploring is the idea of visiting more of the space with the hope that you can actually climb even further.
So which is better then, exploring or exploiting?
Well, you have to trade these off really carefully. So if you're just exploring, it means you're just randomly wandering around the space. You're not using any of the local information to improve yourself. But if you only exploit, then you can get stuck in these local optima. So you need to do a bit of both.
So since I'm always trying to connect this back to stuff we talked before, if you exploit all the time, that's kind of like overfitting, right? It's like believing your data too much and not taking any chances at all. Does that make sense? Or is that too much of a stretch?
It doesn't make sense to me, but I'm sure it makes sense to you.
It makes sense to me.
So you want to think of that as being kind of like overfitting.
Well, you know, if the fundamental problem of overfitting, right, is believing your data too much and dealing with just the coincidences of what you happen to see, that's like being very myopic. And exploiting in this case, only taking the direction which you go, is like believing the data point where you happen to be. I predict from this one example that I should be headed in this direction, and I don't care about anything else, and I'm not going to worry about anything else. Well, that's kind of like believing too much, which is sort of what overfitting is. Meanwhile, search, on the other hand, the exploring is like believing nothing and taking advantage of nothing. So obviously you need to take, as you said, take advantage of the local information. You need to believe it at least a little bit, at least some of the time, or otherwise it's as if you've learned nothing.
All right. Well, I definitely agree with you that there's a trade-off there and that there's a resemblance to overfitting. I don't know how deep that resemblance is.
Superficial. They're like twin cousins.
Twin cousins from another family branch. Mm-hmm. So the simulated annealing algorithm that we're talking about is related to an algorithm called Metropolis Hastings, which I always thought sounded really cool. And the whole idea of it actually gets into metallurgy. So here I drew a picture of a sword. And we want the sword, when we're making a sword, if we're a blacksmith, we're making a sword, we want it to be nice and hard. And the way to make it hard and sharp and well-structured is for all the molecules to be aligned in the same way. So they fit together very snugly and they kind of lock in. And so there is a bit of an optimization process that has to happen. There's all these different ways that the molecules can be arranged. And we would like to settle into an arrangement that has the lowest energy. Well, it turns out that the way that blacksmiths have figured out to do this is they will make the sword and then do repeated heating and cooling. And that actually they can see that actually strengthens the blade. And what's really happening at the molecular level is it's giving the molecules an opportunity to realign themselves to find an even better solution to the problem of how they can all fit into that space. So this annealing is this idea of heating and cooling. And we're not really literally heating and cooling, though, of course, when we run the computer, it is getting a bit hotter. We're just simulating the idea of the temperature changing.